watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television.
You're watching West Hartford Community Television. Yay!
For the community, by the community.
Hi, this is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, welcoming you to Inspired Success, your monthly dose of inspiration power, the program that equips you with the power and inspiration for total success. That is success at work and in life. I want to thank you so much for tuning in. I want to begin the broadcast today by extending special thanks to all of you who not only take your time to watch the broadcast, but also take that extra time to offer me and provide me with your very constructive feedback, your comments, your testimonials. Some of you do it in person when you see me about town, and some of you do it online via email. I want to say a big, big thank you to you. I want to encourage you and ask you to keep those comments and the feedback coming. It helps us to know, it helps me to know how best to continue to serve you. So thank you. And if you haven't ever, you know, taken the time to, you know, write to me or, you know, let me know how the broadcast is kind of really helping you, please, I want to encourage you to really take that time to do that. I really do appreciate it. Thank you so much. Last month on the broadcast, we began a series called Money Power. Money Power is one of my signature training programs. It's the spiritual dimension of financial success. Because like I say, there's more to making money than meets the eye. Financial success is not only a function of sound financial planning and hard work, like we have always been told, and like our present economic meltdown proves. You know, there's more to making money than meets the eye. There's several intangible factors like ideas, inventions, beliefs, connections, timing, favor, goodwill, you know, that really go a long way in impacting our financial success. So this is the series that we began last month. We laid the foundation with the connection principle. And last month we talked about what connections is, what connection is all about. And we said that connection relates to our relationships, our contacts, our associations, and our network. We also talked on the broadcast last month about what our connections speak to, how what it impacts. And we say our connection impacts our reach, our influence, and our visibility. For those of you who missed the broadcast, and or who would like to review it again and watch it, view it again and watch it again to refresh your memory, don't forget that it is available on demand. That means you can watch it at any time. All the videos are available on demand via the internet at either my website at www.royalproclamations.com or at www.whctv.org. So that the video on demand is there for you 24/7 and at your convenience. You can always go back to any of the broadcast. So we're going to be continuing with our series. We're going to be continuing to with the connection principle, with the teaching on our connection principle today. And we're going to be talking about how to establish and build powerful connections. I'm going to repeat that again. How to establish and build powerful connections. We know from the broadcast last month, we already know that connections, we know how connections impact our financial success or our success in general, our success in life in general. But this broadcast will be focused on how to actually do it, how to establish, how to build those powerful connections. I want to really invite you, you know, to take down notes. You know, there's going to be a lot of invaluable information that I'll be sharing with us on this broadcast. And so I want to encourage you to be studious and get your notepad and paper and get ready to take down some notes. And don't forget that I promise that at the end of the series, I'm going to be having a viewer's reception. Actually, it's going to be on February 12, 2010. It's a viewer's reception as well as the official launch of this TV broadcast. And it's going to be right here at the West Hartford Town Hall Auditorium. So save that date. And, you know, viewers who come and can prove, you know, by showing their notes that they've been following this program conscientiously, I'll be giving away prizes. I'll be offering them a 45-minute free coaching session, you know, one-on-one with me. And so I want to really, I'm encouraging you. That's the incentive, really, to really take this program very seriously and really kind of really, you know, consider it a learning opportunity and take some notes. So like I said, we're talking about how to establish and build powerful connections. Remember that last time in our broadcast, on the broadcast, I said that there are three areas, there are three connections that we must make. Number one is that we must make our upward, our divine connection. Number two, we must make our outward or what I call people connection. And we must make our inner or core connection to really be able to thrive financially. And so I'm going to be looking at establishing and building powerful connections in those three areas. So the first one, again, is how to establish and build a powerful connection spiritually with God, with the Almighty. You know, remember I said last time that this is the individual who rules the waves. He's everywhere. He's omnipresent, you know, and he has connections in China, in every continent, in Asia, in Europe, in Africa, in every continent of the world. He has the hearts of kings and queens and presidents in his hands. And I was, you know, telling us, I said, you know, you can imagine being connected with someone so powerful, the kind of influence you will be wielding and the kind of, influence and power that you'll be wielding as a result of that connection with God. So, but how do we establish, how do we build, that's the question today, a powerful connection with God? The first step is really to believe, You have to believe in God, you know. You have to believe that he is and he is a rewarder of those who diligently seek him. You have to believe that he exists, that he is God, and that he can do what he says he will do. So that's the first step, is to believe. Believe in the divine, believe in God, believe in the spiritual, you know, believe in the Almighty God, in a creator. That's the first step. The second step is to repent. Because, you see, there are many gods out there with a small g, but the true and the living God, there's only one true and living God. The true and the living God is a holy and a righteous God. But we on our part are sinners. All have sinned and come short of the glory of God, myself included. You know, we're all sinners, you know. We've all sinned. We've all lied. You know, if you're going to be honest with yourself, you've lied, you've cheated, you've stolen. You know, we've done all bad things. So by reason of our Adamic nature, we're all sinners. So the second step in establishing a connection, you know, with God, with the divine, is to repent of those sins, you know, to make up our mind that we're going to make that U-turn and going to, you know, begin to have a relationship with him based on his own values. You know, the one thing about relationship is that one of the major relationship killers is if you're doing something, you know, in a relationship to one of the parties that the other person doesn't appreciate, that the other person doesn't like. That's the number one way to kill any relationship. So, you know, the second step is to repent of our sins and to make up our minds that we want to now begin to relate with God, you know, and commune with God and have a relationship with God based on his values, based on holiness and righteousness. And then the third thing to do, the third step, is to now believe on the substitutionary sacrifice that God has provided for us. There is a mediator, you know, because what our sin does is our sin separates us from God. You know, it builds a wall between us and God, because God is holy and righteous and he cannot behold sin. He cannot look on sin. He cannot relate with someone or some, you know, thing that is unclean and unrighteous. So what God did is he provided a propitiation for our sins. He provided a sacrifice for our sin in the person of his son, Jesus Christ. And so the third step in establishing that relationship with God is to believe on Jesus Christ, is to accept him into our lives, to accept his sacrificial act of dying for our sins on the cross of Calvary. And once we do that, we accept it, and the blood of Jesus cleanses us. And then the door is open for us to begin to have that interaction with God. So that's the first, those are the three steps in establishing relationship, our upward relationship, you know, our upward connection. Those are the three steps: believe, repent, and accept Jesus. And then once that has been done, we've established the relationship. Like I said, the door is open, and you know, God is free now to relate with us, to commune with us, because now he doesn't see us through our sins. He sees us through the blood of Christ, through our faith in Christ. And then we in turn have the opportunity to also, you know, continue to relate with him. And so in building that relationship is the same thing. You know, we continue in prayer, regular communication. Everybody knows that one of the principles for building strong and powerful relationships or connections is effective communication. You must be in dialogue. And so we grow, we build the powerful connection with the supernatural through prayer and through regular communion, you know, with God. So now we've established how to build our powerful connection with God. Now I want to talk about our connections with people, what I refer to as our outward connection. How do we do it? How do we establish and how do we build powerful connections with people? Because, you know, we've laid it down. We've already established this fact at the beginning of our series, that people are bridges. People are doorkeepers. People are gatekeepers. You know, success in life is dependent upon who you know, upon your connections. So how do you establish those connections? How do you make those connections? How do you build it? Is what we're going to be talking about now. Now, the number one step to, and the key, is to get out there and network. The word is called networking, okay? You need to get out of your cubicle, get out of your house, and go to the places where people congregate. Go to the places you're wanting to build powerful connections. Go to the places where powerful people congregate. And that's just it. That's a simple thing to do. You know, unfortunately, many of us have what my colleague and my friend Karen Hines referred to, and I'll be going to be recommending her book, by the way, as a resource for you later in the broadcast. Her book is called Networking for a Better Position and More Profit. I'm going to be talking a little bit more about Karen's book later in the broadcast. But she refers to something a cubicle mentality. And this is what many of us have. This is many of us' attitude to our work. We have this cubicle mentality, which is we just stay behind our desk and, you know, we do our work and that's it. We don't interact with people in the at work. We don't hang out. We don't go to lunch with them. We never attend any company social events, you know, the the holiday parties, the Christmas parties, whatever. No, we never attend. That's a cubicle mentality, like Karen calls it, to life and to work and to networking. And at the end of the day, you don't know anybody. You don't even know anybody. You don't have any connections within the company. You don't have any connections outside of work. And then, you know, what happens when you lose your job or your job is being threatened, you know? And that's when people develop what I call a fire brigade attitude to networking. Fire brigade attitude. That is, you know, it is more reactionary. It's more a defensive kind of networking when you are in a crisis or when a crisis is brewing in your career, then you start networking. No, networking should be proactive. It should be something, it should be a lifestyle attitude, because based on our understanding that people are valuable, people are the most valuable resource that exists for us as human beings on this planet. Okay, so the first step is in you know, knowing how to establish and build these powerful connections with people, our outward connections, like I call it, is to value people. It's to value people. You know what I say? What we don't know, we don't value. I'll say that again. What we don't know, we don't value. And what we don't value, we abuse. We misuse or don't use. So the first step in really getting to networking and getting out there to network is to begin to value networking, value people. Consider it as a major part of your life, you know. People, building relationships must be paramount and important to you. You know, if it helps you at all, you know, I'm not trying to say it in a negative way. When you see people, see a dollar sign on their forehead. People means dollar. People means money. Okay? And so you start valuing people the same way you value if I gave you a $100 bill or if I put down $10,000 before you. The same way you value those money is the same way you value people, because your connections with people will influence your bottom line. So that's the first step, value people. The next step is to prepare. You know, it never ceases to amaze me how many people, you know, are just unprepared when they go out to quote and unquote network. It's an intentional thing, you know. It's an intentional thing. So you must prepare. You must prepare by defining your brand and by defining your pitch. Who am I? And what am I trying to market about myself? You know, that must be clear in not more than two or three sentences, okay? And the other thing is you must also prepare your material. You know, you must have your contact information, usually in a business card, even if you're looking for work, okay? Have all that info, because you may meet two or three or four or five people, or five or three or more people may meet you. And of course, you don't expect them to remember, you know, all your information in their head. So you give them something that they can take away and review, okay? So make sure you're prepared. Anywhere I go, I'm ever ready. I'm ever ready. I'm fully armed. Even if I go to the movies, I'm fully armed. In my pocketbook, their business cards. I'm ready at any time to pitch, to tell people who I am and what I do. Because anywhere people congregate is a potential place for you to network and meet people, okay? So that's the next step in establishing those connections. And then the third step is that you follow up, okay? So and you keep keeping a database of your contacts. Keep a good database of your contacts and categorize them. So after that, you've networked or you met somebody, keep a database, keep their contact info somewhere safe. You know, there's a lot of electronic programs and things, formats that you can do that. And so you keep a database and then you follow up. Follow up, you know, electronically, follow up via telephone, follow up in person, you know, meet them for lunch, try and get to know them a little bit better. That's now you're coming to the building of that relationship. After it's been established, you're coming to the building of it. And also give value in trying to build a relationship, a powerful connections. You know, you give value. So you're bringing something of value to the table, you know, and that people are, would respond to you and be wanting to even spend their time with you because they will consider you as a value, an invaluable resource to them. So bring value to the table. Be generous with your ideas, with your gifts, and with your talents, you know, and you will be amazed how it will come back to you in so many different ways. And then as far as the fourth thing that you need to do in terms of building those powerful connections after you follow up is watch out for your integrity, you know, because, you know, they say that people do business with those they know, the like, and the trust. So in building a powerful connection, make sure that you keep your word, that your word is your bond, and that people come to know you and trust you as a person of integrity. That is, you do what you say you do, and you keep to your word. So those are the steps as far as our outward relationship, our people connections are concerned. And, you know, this is really something that I'm very, very passionate about. I can't seem to be able to get the word out to people enough, you know. I can't because, you know, people would, especially now where, you know, there's so many unemployed people. It's about who you know. It's about the information that you have access to. Like I was saying in one of my previous broadcasts, 8 out of 10 of the jobs are already filled before they ever advertise publicly. So really, it's about who you know and how, what kind of information you're able to have access to. And it's about how big, how broad your connections and your network is. So I really can't really seem to preach this gospel strong enough. I can't seem to really get it into us and buttress it enough. And if you're having struggling in that area, because, you know, people tell me, oh, I'm just not a people person. I just don't like people. I'm like, hello. You better get out of this planet if you don't like people, because as far as this planet, universe called Earth is concerned, it's run by people, not aliens, okay? So you better get to like people and better improve on your people skills. And of course, you know that I can help you. That's my passion. I'm the queen of networking, the self-styled queen of networking, and I'm always available to help you individually, one-on-one, to coach you on how to really build those profitable, those powerful connections. And I'm also available in a group setting to speak and to teach and, you know, to really kind of just encourage you to learn more about how to do it. So visit me at my website, www.royalproclamations, to learn more about what I offer in that area. So, you know, we've been able to look so far at how to establish and build two of our most powerful and needed connections. That's our upward. We've looked at the upward relationship, our upward connection with God. We've looked at that, and we've talked about how we build that through, you know, belief, through believing in the Lord and through accepting his son, Jesus Christ, and through constant communion and fellowship and through obedience and living our lives according to his values and precepts as, you know, defined in his word. So we've looked at that, and we've also looked at our people connection, how to, you know, how to establish and build it. I've talked about how you need to get out there, get out of your box, okay? Get out of your comfort zone and get out there where people congregate and do it. And also, you know, social networking sites. Now we're living in a virtual world, you know, community now. And so I must mention that that's also a good way of networking. Facebook, we're all aware of Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, and all those ways. Those are some social networking sites where you can also network with people and really kind of get the word out there about who you are, make those powerful connections. Okay, so finally, we're coming towards the end of the broadcast, and finally, I'm talking about how to make that powerful connection within yourself. Because remember the last time on the broadcast, I was saying that many, many of us are not living our true and authentic self. We are not connected to the core of who we are on the inside. We're living a life that we think we should be living, or we believe we should be living, or that society or somebody tells us we should be living. We're not living our true lives, okay? And until we connect with our inner self, with the core of who we are, our purpose, our passion, honestly and truly, we cannot really excel at what we do. And obviously, we're not excellent at what we do. You know, your bottom line is going to be down, 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 down. So, you know, that's how that works. So in establishing and connecting and building the relationship with your inner self, the key to doing that is to find time alone with yourself. Get alone with yourself. Solace, you know, quietness, you know. In quietness and confidence shall your strength be. Find time regularly to retreat, you know, and just get quiet alone with your thoughts and, you know, try and reach on the inside of yourself and ask yourself these questions. Who am I? What are my values? What are my passions? Where am I going? Where would I like to go? Well, what are my dreams? What are my goals as far as life and business and, you know, my finances are concerned? And how far am I away from those goals? And what steps can I take to reach those goals, you know? So regular times of, you know, getting alone with your thoughts, with yourself, with God is just one of the most powerful ways of making that inner connection. This is something that I practice so much, I believe so much in, because, you know, it just fuels and energizes when we get to do that. For example, my birthday will be 2 days from now, it'll be 2 days from now, and the gift I'm giving myself is a day retreat. I'm going away somewhere quiet where I can just be alone with myself, with God, and commune and meditate and strategize and, you know, measure, evaluate where I am vis-a-vis my goals, you know, and how to also, you know, get to where I'm trying to reach. So, you know, that's one powerful way of really kind of establishing and building that inner connection, and that is solace and quietness and meditation and, you know, those kind of retreats. So, you know, you got it out there today. You've got all the information that you need as far as establishing and building powerful connections. And the ball is now in your court. It's just for you to do it so that you're not only a hearer only. Many times we just hear and we hear and we hear the same message, but we never apply what we do, what we learn. Okay, so I want to encourage you that you should go out and begin to do and implement all these principles and just watch your life kind of turn around for better. Okay, so we're coming to the end of our broadcast. I told you that I have some a resource to recommend to us. It's my friend and my colleague. Her name is Karen Hides, and she's written this very small but powerful book about networking for a better position and more profit. I really believe that this would really help you to develop and build your skills, your networking skills. I would also like to use this opportunity to invite you on the road. I thank you for all those who come out to my events. Many of the seniors came out to the Staying Alive workshop that I had on October 20th. So I want to say thank you to that, to all of you who turned up. And but, you know, I want to invite you to join me on the road. If you have never seen me live in person, this is always an opportunity. So join me on November 14th, 2009. I'll be at the First Congregational Church in West Hartford. First Congregational Church in West Hartford on 12 South Main Street. And for a ladies' prayer breakfast on Saturday, November 14, 2009. And that's another spiritual principle for financial success that we're going to be looking at later. It's a prayer principle. Prayer is a very powerful thing that works. Believe me, take it from me. And then December 9th through the 23rd is my annual Operation Joy to the World, where I take my inspirational message on the go into the homeless shelter and to the community. And you're welcome to join me to volunteer your time and or donate your gifts for that program. February 12th, don't forget, is an evening of inspired success. You can learn more about all these upcoming events and as well as get a hold of all the resources that are needed and learn more about all my programs, my training, coaching, and speaking programs at www.royalproclamations.com. This is Princess Bola Adelani, the Total Success Coach, reminding you to keep smiling. Come on, keep smiling, okay? It's not that bad. Life isn't that bad. Keep learning. Keep networking. Keep believing. Keep on keeping on. You're on the winning side. I'll see you next month as we continue with our Money Power series and learn about beliefs. Take care and God bless. Bye-bye.